Then we will hold a postal vote on this issue, asking the same question, in which all Australians will have their say. They will get the opportunity to express their opinion on the issue of whether the law should be changed to enable same-sex couples to marry.
So the ABS was given quite a challenge with the requirement to undertake this survey within essentially less than 100 days. So we did have some initial conversations at the ABS about how we would do it and whether it was actually possible. So we did come to a fairly firm conclusion that it was possible and that it was certainly quite challenging for the ABS. But certainly with the skills and attributes that we had at the organisation and the experience and expertise that we had from the last census, we were confident that we could deliver this survey.
So some of the challenges for this survey are obviously that we've got a very short period of time and a very large operation to run. So right across that country we need to get our materials out in a quick kind of time period, give people sufficient time to complete their surveys and get them back in order to produce the results within 99 days of when we first started it out. So it's really about time, it's about logistics, it's about trying to get everything done in a really smooth and efficient way.
We've had three hearings with a Senate inquiry, preparing for, producing two submissions and appearing at those hearings have been incredible achievements and milestones.
For the first time, Australia's electoral roll has over 16 million people. It shows just how important this survey is to people, how much interest it's gathered.
The program that we're working on is obviously not a typical sort of government program. We've got a heck of a lot of work to deliver in a very short space of time. From an agile point of view, this is a new way of working, I guess, for a lot of the people on the task force. And so it's been trying to find the activities, the practices, the behaviours that make most sense to use.
When you're conducting a normal Australian government advertising campaign, the process from getting the go-ahead to right to the end of when ads are first launched usually takes around 6 to 12 months. So for us, when the Australian Treasurer announced this campaign, we had ads rolled out the door within 36 hours, which is really quite phenomenal. And that was on TV, press, radio and online advertising.
We've been speaking to people from culturally and linguistically diverse backgrounds about their participation, people with a disability, people experiencing homelessness, people in residential aged care, trying to reach some of our more far-flung places like Norfolk Island, Christmas Island, and even the Australian Antarctic Territories, places that you might not think about when you think about surveying Australians about their views.
So pick-up locations and inclusive strategies is really about ensuring everyone has equal opportunity to participate in the survey. To date, we've actually trained 150 staff who are going to be volunteering to sit on these pick-up location desks. They'll be the customer-facing, they'll be the ones that are going to interact with the public, provide them with that support.
The reason we come up with an inclusive strategy for our remote communities, particularly those with Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander populations in the north, was a range of challenges they'd have in participating in the survey. So predominantly post is an issue, so a lot of post to remote areas only goes to a postal agent, so it doesn't go to an address, and language issues as well. We tried to reach out to about 250 communities across the top end, so the majority of NT, Cape York, Torres Strait, Kimberley and a little bit further south in WAN in South Australia.
For me, I started in the task force on a Tuesday and I was told that we had to get a website released by Friday. We've had more than 1 million page views to the website since launch on the Saturday, 9th of September.
Part of producing systems of this scale, you have to do some large scale volume testing. One of the tests we did was a major DDoS test, which had 1 million hits per second tested on the online response form. So that's kind of daunting in world terms, not just Australian terms.
To be able to dispatch, well not only dispatch, but print, personalise, undertake some rigorous print quality control, put them into envelopes and then dispatch to 16 million Australians around the country was quite a challenging exercise. And to give you a bit of an idea, we had 25 days from the day we were directed by the government to run the survey to actually finish printing. And we had 32 days from the day we were notified by the government to actually start delivery. And to put that in context, for the census, we had somewhere around the 9 months of planning. So what took us 9 months in the census, took us 38 days for the marriage law survey.
We've not only done this at the ABS, but we've done it in concert with a whole range of other agencies, and they've been very enthusiastic and very strong supporters of this process. And I just want to recognise certainly the contributions that a number of those agencies, including the Electoral Commission, the Department of Human Services, Australia Post, Australian Signals Directorate and others have made to this process being as complete as it is and for the process to run as smoothly as it has.
Obviously Australia Post played a major role. Within 3 days of ABS being notified by the government to run the surveys, Australia Post had already mobilised their project team as well as started some initial planning.
DHS are assisting the ABS in two ways with the marriage survey. One is with the delivery of contact centre services for the information line, and the other is assistance in implementing their remote strategies across the top end of Australia.
AWS's goals with the marriage survey platform was to, we wanted to make sure that the system made every effort to keep citizens' privacy throughout the life cycle of the data that was collected. We needed to make sure that the data was stored safely and securely, and we wanted to make sure that the integrity of the data couldn't be compromised at any stage. We didn't really have an understanding of how many people were going to use the system, so we effectively planned for the whole of Australia to use the system. And we also wanted to make sure it was resilient. We needed to make sure that it could handle any sort of component failure, even things like an entire data centre going down.
Australia Post actually supply daily deliveries of the survey returns to the Fuji Xerox sites across the five main capital cities. They've been relocated to a temporary storage location in our warehouse, where they're under 24/7 security guard. The very first process that takes place is actually the mail opening of the envelopes, and they go through a mechanical process where they're actually opened. From there, they're transferred to the extraction unit, and you see that those individuals behind me wear their, you know, the masks and the gowns. They are literally taking the forms out of those envelopes and they're transferred into our scanning area. The recognition software identifies the yeses and nos. Anything that is not a clear yes or no, or has additional information, is then supplied to what we call a manual validation step.
From a strategic level, the online form is really important to the ABS. So we want to make sure that any solution we're putting out there on the web is robust enough to not go down at any point, and make sure that we are really confident about how the data is secured.
So we provide a range of support for business owners, so people that actually own the key processes or systems, and they provide requirements to us. We effectively go off and communicate with our technical developers. We develop those processes, test them, and then release them to business owners ready for use.
Australians are actually getting a response to anything that they might have concerns over, and we're mitigating those within an hour.
The strategic goal of data protection is that we appropriately assure and mitigate and control the risk that we have to our data. Really prioritise the assessment of risks to key systems and processes, and actually put in place things which reduce the risk. We put them in place as we're building those systems and processes, which is wonderful and means that security and protection is actually baked into our solutions.
And we've achieved a lot, I think, in a few short weeks, particularly looking at physical security in the first instance, and then later in the IT security space, making sure that the online form, the voice response that we have for the vision impaired people is also appropriately secured, and that we have an online response form which is resilient and which will scale well.
Really, our strategic goals for the privacy elements of the task force are to ensure that we deliver a privacy compliant program that meets the requirements of the Australian privacy principles, and we help provide advice on the lawfulness of the activities in the conduct of the survey.
So observers are there to provide an external, assurance to the public and to the government that the ABS conducted the survey with integrity and conducted it accurately. So we invited these observers in, basically to have a look at some of the survey forms. I saw about 600,000 of them, and they provided us with feedback on whether they thought we had the decision right.
With the destruction, we not only destroyed the completed survey forms, but we also completed all the return to sender mail that we got through the survey, also any of the unused envelopes and used envelopes that any of our Australian citizens return through the process. The ABS selected Iron Mountain as we needed a company with a proven track record in secure document destruction, but we also needed a company that had a footprint across Australia, and Iron Mountain have decades of experience in that.
The dissemination process is quite a lengthy one. We've just today got through our final run of data and we now have the complete picture. What will happen now is that we will thoroughly quality assure that, and then we will start dropping that data into all the templates we've created over the last couple of months. So we've spent a lot of time developing words that explain the data, that have explained the survey process, the measures we've put in place to ensure integrity across all those points in the process as well. And now it's time to update all that content with the actual data, which is the really exciting part.
One of the amazing things about the release day was actually just going into the press conference. I suppose it struck me just the significance of what we'd achieved, and not just the significance of it, but the very keen public interest.
And now the official results of the Australian Marriage Law Postal Survey. For the national result, yes responses, 7,817,247, representing 61.6% of clear responses. No responses, 4,873,987, representing 38.4% of clear responses.
The Australian people have spoken in their millions, and they have voted overwhelmingly yes for marriage equality.
Government thought that the Marriage Postal Survey was a great success. One of the things that was quite important was the decision by the statistician early on to take the maximum amount of control over the delivery of the exercise. That was very important, I think, in terms of enabling us to be able to move as quickly as possible when issues arose and be able to plan the thing end to end as a single exercise rather than a fragmented one.
In 20 years' time, I think the real emphasis will be on the date on which the legislation was passed. But there'll always be mention made, I think, of the survey that was behind that, that everyone participated in and gave the politicians, our parliament, the confidence that they had a clear gauge of Australians' views on that matter.
I think this really shows how the ABS informs Australia's important decisions.